Tom, do you want to tell me about the sheep, the duck, and the rooster?
You bet, Beth. They were the first living creatures to fly. The Montgolfier brothers sent them up from the palace at Versailles in September 1783. People had flown the first small balloons, but they weren't really sure if there was air up there. So they flew the animals to prove that there was air up there.
A few months later, on November 21st, the Montgolfier brothers assisted Jean-François Pilatre de Rosier and François-Laurent d'Arlandes in becoming the first humans to successfully perform a free, untethered flight. Chemical scientist Jacques-Alexandre César Charles was also experimenting with flight by utilizing hydrogen, the lightest element to exist. On December 1st of that same year, Charles became the first to take flight in a hydrogen-filled balloon. Another revitalization took place in the 1950s when Ed Yost developed an onboard heat source to extend flights by burning kerosene. His invention allowed a balloon to carry a pilot up to 10,000 feet, remain in the air for 3 hours, and be reused. In 2016, Bill Costen became the first African-American to receive the Ed Yost Master Pilot Lifetime Achievement Award. The award recognizes lighter-than-air pilots who have demonstrated skill and expertise by maintaining safe operations for 40 or more consecutive years.
Most people, it was their lifelong dream to go up in a balloon. So my thrill was watching their faces and gestures and everything as they were looking out over the countryside. You know, looking at the different scenes and everything, they were saying, oh, wow, look at this. Oh, wow, look at that. But flying 40 years of a balloon and not having an accident and taking up thousands of people and thousands of hours, you just experience everything. I mean, good and bad. I mean, I had hairy experiences, beautiful experiences. Sometimes you just can't control the winds at all. You just got to pick the best landing spot you can pick and hopefully land there. So I was successful in doing that for 40 years and becoming the first and probably only Black master pilot in the country actually means everything. But the main thing was taking people up for rides.
Where would you like to fly over in a hot air balloon? Let us know in the comments section. And if you like this video, be sure to follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.